Hi guys, and welcome to part two of our Scorpion Girl color along. We'll be wrapping up the skin today. The rest of the skin, I would like to show you how the neck and the hand and arms will be done. So that's the plan for today, and I will just jump right into it. I already added a base to the neck and the hands, so we will be adding the base colors again, and then we will go on. So I'm starting with white. I will just add more white where I want the highlights to be. So as I told you last time, we are working on tone 10 paper, which takes much more layers than regular white paper. So when you watch this tutorial, I would advise you to go back and add even more layers of the colors than I do, because if it wouldn't be, you know, a tutorial type of video, if I was working on, you know, by myself without the camera, I would be adding more layers. Even more. I'm adding the colors which are necessary and the layers. And where is my buff titanium? Okay. So buff titanium. Then we have cream. I'm putting cream next to the white areas. But also everywhere, just to get rid of the, you know, the strokes which are visible, to get some pigment into the teeth of the paper. Here too. Then we have beige. Going over the whole area except the whites. With circular movements. My gosh, this is such a stunning painting or artwork. Don't you agree? So amazing. Back to cream. going over the highlights. Then burnt ochre 10%. As a sharpener, I'm using my Tigo multi-sharpener. I will leave her mouth blank on purpose, as I want to adjust the color of her lipstick to the, you know, the theme of the page. Maybe I will go with pinks and whites for the flower. So I might do some kind of nude mouth coloring. And the colors are blending in together. We can see less and less of the tooth, the harshness of the paper, which is our goal, or my goal here. Gonna go back in with white. Buff titanium. Cream. Cream will add the transition between our white highlight or lightest skin color. White, buff titanium, cream. Then we have beige, and then we add burnt ochre 10%. Burnt ochre 10. Ooh, that's the first time this happens to me. Look. Now to adding the pink to the skin, deco pink. Because every skin has some pink color in it. I'm gonna add pink to the nails here, too. Then we have blush pink. You don't need much of blush pink, just a little. Around the darkest parts of the fingers, here in the middle of her hands, and some around the arms. Okay, now to Sienna Brown. You can be generous with Sienna Brown. Look for the card here under the neck. Okay, here in the again the shadow areas of the fingers. gonna add some of the brown here in the middle. Here. It might li look a little bit weird for now, but we will go back in with some lighter colors to build up the transition. Between the middle part, which is the highlighted area, and you know, the two sides of the arm. To rosy beige, which will mute down our brown color a bit. So I'm going over all the areas of sienna brown with rosy beige, even at the neck. This will help to merge, blend the colors together, because sienna brown in itself will be and is in my opinion a little bit too brown and dark for this specific skin color, but with going over rosy beige on top, it will, knock back on the brown color. It will be still brown, but a more muted, pinkish tone will appear. Still working with rosy beige, blending colors in. Let's take a look from afar. We are getting there. Okay. I'm gonna add some deco pink again. Beige. Going over the whole hand and arms, especially the highlighted areas, again blending the dark areas with the light ones together, leaving the whitest parts white. Again, using white. gonna add more of the brown, sienna brown. Neck. I'm using a really light pressure. Circular movements. Yay, it's starting to come to life. You have to be patient. That's all, and just keep going with the layers. Well, it's not all, but it's very important. Don't stop midway. Then some blush pink. Going over blush pink and over the whole brown area, just using medium pressure. And rosy beige. Blending the brown with the lighter skin areas. This color is like the burnt sienna 10% in the Lumis. Now I'm gonna add burnt sienna luminance to the shadows. Then sienna brown. Blush pink. Oops. Burnt ochre 10%. Beige. White. Pharma violet. Adding this violet to the shadow area. And espresso. And a little thin line of espresso around her face and the neck meet. And we will need some black too. Just in the corner. Good. Yeah, so the neck is done. Now to the hands. Yeah, next up will be burnt sienna. Yeah. Burnt sienna. These fingers are so tiny. I hope you can see something. Okay, now I'm going over the area with beige. Where is my beige? And with the whole area, I mean where I put my burnt sienna. I will add some Parma violet. Shadows. Blush pink. Parma violet here. Here between the fingers. Have some espresso here. And some here at the bottom. And black here. Let's see how it looks so far. Okay, we still have a few minutes, so I will go back and add more color to the face. I think we can do with some more brown. Yep. So, sienna brown. Adding some brown here too. Now we will need rosy beige or no, burnt ochre 10% first. Now we need blush pink. Blush pink. There you are. Oops. Now we need deco pink. Now I'm going to blend the darker skin color to the beige and cream in the middle. Just wanted to add some pink to her face. And now we need beige. Yep. And cream. And white. And again, Sienna Brown. This part will stay white as this is where the light is reflected. So I'm not going over with brown there, but underneath the lips and here at the chin, I'm adding some brown. The forehead, the skin will look much better once we have the hair done. Now it looks a little bit weird, but that will change. And now we need rosy beige. blending our brown together with the other skin tones with rosy beige. Oops. Sorry. And even a little bit more brown here in the forehead, sienna brown. Okay. Good. Take a look from further away. All right. I will switch off the focus so it won't be so blurry. I'm just looking at the picture. Yeah, I will add a sienna brown here. We burnt sienna, I mean, to the ears. Yeah, good. And a little bit of burnt sienna at the edges. So, apart from adding some burnt sienna here, I want add more shading colors to the forehead because I want the hair to be done first, and after that we can decide if the forehead needs more shading. Yep. I'm pretty happy with how this is looking, and let me just fix a few things before I say goodbye. You know, skin is like that. I feel like it's never really done. Yeah, I will add a little bit more of blush pink here. To give it a more healthy complexion, blush. Good. All right. So this was part two of our color along. I hope you found. Maybe I will add some here. Yeah, I hope you found. Yeah, I'm adding just some cream here, just softening the edges of the highlight. Good. So, I hope you found this tutorial helpful. We will go on with part three really soon. So, I'm pretty sure you know the skin will look much better once we have the hair done and we have the background and the context around it. So, and of course, we still need to finish her lips, but I will do that at the very end because this will be like, you know, the center of, you know, the attention, her face and her lip. So I will wait for the colors that will be put down here to decide which color I want her lips to be. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you are interested in skin tutorials, there is a skin tutorial playlist on my channel as well. Yeah, so see you next time and bye.